A bird-inspired drone developed by EPFL uses artificial wings made of fiberglass covered in nylon, which allow for easier maneuverability in high winds. And SALTO, the leaping robot from UC Berkeley, has the highest robotic vertical jump and can even wall jump. Look at SALTO! I love SALTO! Vsauce, Kevin here. This is MindGlow. Kissenger lets you send and receive kisses through your phone. The attachment features high-precision force sensors under a silicon lip to measure your kiss and transmit it to the device on the kiss receiver's phone. This actually isn't a new idea. In fact, MindBlow 16 back in 2011 and on Vsauce 1, and MindBlow 46 in 2012 covered prototypes for robot kissing devices. There was even another device named Kissenger by a company called Lovotics, but it looks like this new Kissenger from Mixed Reality Lab is the most practical yet, since it's significantly more compact and interfaces directly with your phone. Base Systems envisions a future where lenses are made with laser beams controlling hot air bubbles. The laser-developed atmospheric lens system creates lenses by layering hot air bubbles on colder air, using laser pulses which then refract light. This concept is similar to how current solid lenses made of plastic or glass work, but making one out of air would allow it to be much larger and maneuverable. This technique could also be used to deflect laser attacks by dispersing the beam. So basically like laser beam shields in sci-fi movies, but it's just a concept for now. There's no prototype. Yet. WaveOptics is developing wearable augmented reality technology to overlay computer graphics on the real world. Their headset, nicknamed the Ghost, is designed for developers and not as a consumer device. And they say their fully transparent display creates sharp holograms with a wide field of view. Their proof of concept video shows how this could be used in work and leisure scenarios, basically getting one step closer to turning the world into a video game. ICAROS is a fitness flying virtual reality game controller machine. The active VR experience connects wirelessly to a headset and demands your full body to control flying through the game. Navigating inside the rings requires shifting your weight, and this thing is more like a futuristic exercise device than a gaming peripheral. Alright, that's the last VR story for this episode. Okay, one more VR story. axonVR wants you to feel virtual reality. The HapX is a haptic textile that can provide vibration, tactile, and thermal feedback for feeling virtual shape, texture, weight, and temperature. They claim the range of touch varies from the brush of a butterfly's wing to the impact of a punch. And the goal is for their system to be available in theme parks and arcades, and not likely in your house, unfortunately. A soft robotic sleeve can restore normal blood flow after heart failure. Traditionally, a failing heart has its blood removed and passed through tubes and pumps, which increase the risk of blood clotting. But this new device works without contacting blood. There's still more work to be done before this moves onto human trials, but soft robot heart pumping is awesome, and I just wanted to show you. So, yeah. The sun and footsteps are all that are needed to power these new streetlights. EnGo Planet installed kinetic tiles in Las Vegas to help power streetlights, Wi-Fi hotspots, video surveillance, and USB ports for mobile device charging. The panels generate between 4 to 8 watts from pedestrian foot traffic, and dependent on the success of this 4-light trial, the plan is to roll out large-scale installations on the Vegas Strip and in New York City parks. EnChroma are glasses designed to alleviate red-green color blindness. The lenses feature a patent-pending multi-notch filter, which cut out sharp wavelengths of light to enhance specific colors and separate the red and green cones. This helps to counter the overlap between red and green, which affects those with that form of color blindness. These allow people, for instance, to easily identify the color difference between a green traffic light and a blue sky background. Finally, researchers at Intel Labs created an algorithm for mobile robots to navigate cluttered environments. The Quadcopter is able to reach its goal through this maze and navigate 200 interwoven strings and 20 poles. It's a fun drone obstacle course. I'm gonna leave you with large-scale programmable disassembly of tiny robots. And as always, thanks for watching.
are picked up by this wonderful mechanical ear, the microphone, which is really a glorified telephone transmitter. The power from the microphones is amplified about 10 million times by these vacuum tubes, making the voice current strong enough to operate the machine that photographs the sound. Do you follow me? And then this amplified current is carried by wires along through the theater and down to the screen on the stage to connect with the loudspeakers. This is a typical layout of the stage set with two horns behind the screen. The receivers connected to the horns convert the electrical vibrations back into sound waves exactly the way the telephone receiver operates, so that while the picture is being shown, the sound which was recorded is reproduced in step with the picture. The screen is full of small holes so that the horns may be placed behind the screen to let the sound through. This gives the illusion that the sound is coming from the image of the speaker. Simple, isn't it? Huh?